Godot 4.0 was released in March 2023 with an almost full rewrite. There were so many new features that it took a 30-minute video to cover everything. With the amount of changes, Godot 4.0 needed a ton of testing and polish. This is exactly what the Godot developers focused on for this release, as they promised. Godot 4.1 brings over 1,000 fixes and improvements contributed by 300 people. These improvements include the ability to detach script editors into separate windows and new and much more powerful AI avoidance. Let's look at the biggest improvements and features in this release. Starting with the Godot editor, you can now undock code editors, be it the shader or scripting interfaces. To do so, click on this icon with the floating window, and it will pop a new window that you can resize and move even to a separate display. To dock back the interface, close the window as usual. For the scripting editor, the icon is in the top right, so you can click it to pop it out of there. And note that Godot will now remember where the windows are next time you restart. You can now export arrays of nodes to the inspector. If I go to my DAW script, I'm just using the export annotation as usual, and it's all controlled by the type of my variable, array of whatever you need. So in the inspector, then, when I try to add nodes to this array, Godot will automatically gray out anything that doesn't match and highlight the nodes that match. This is great for situations like these where I have a door, I want it to open only when all corresponding buttons are pressed, which is a common puzzle game mechanic. Arrays of exported nodes are perfect for that. A common issue with model direction and the lookout function in Godot is that models end up looking backward. This is because Godot uses the camera direction as the reference for determining what is forward. You can now use the model space as a reference for the forward direction. To do so, you need to add first a second argument, the up vector, and then set the third argument, use model front, to true. This is new in Godot 4, and it will make your model look in the direction you want. If you have many Godot projects on your computer, you'll be happy to see the new tags feature in the project manager. You can click a project to select it and click Manage Tags on the right to change the tags on this project or create new ones. Then, if you click the tag buttons on the project list, it will quickly filter the list of projects to quickly find the one you're looking for. On the rendering side, the reworked turbulence gives you a lot more control over complex particle effects, such as these petals flowing in the wind. Since Godot 4, you can use volumetric fogs and fog volume nodes to fill areas with dense fog. From Godot 4.1, you can create 3D noise textures to control their density. I've created one here that I'll load, and you can see that it changes the shape and feel of my fog in 3D space. In C#, the focus has been on bridging the gap with GDScript's feature set. So you could not create a custom class and register it in the Add Node dialog until Godot 4.1. This is now possible by adding the global class attribute. Once you've done that, the node type will appear in the Add New Node dialog. A very powerful feature in Godot is the offline instant access to the full class reference right in the editor. This gives you quick access to all of the technical documentation you need to code. In case you didn't know, Godot can also generate these documentation pages from your custom code. To do that, you define a class name and you create docstrings, in GDScript at least, by using the double hash sign for comments instead of a single one. Once you've done that, you can look for your class name and you will get a page dedicated to it with all your docstrings. So this is great for plugins and whatnot. Godot 4.1 gives you now the ability to use inline doc strings instead of always having to put them above a variable or another definition. And it also improves the generated documentation in complex cases. Before, it would sometimes not catch the types you are working with, but now it does that accurately even for inner classes. Very often in Godot, when you need shared data between instances of a class, such as these balls here, you need to use an autoload or a resource, but it can be a bit inconvenient. Let's say that I need to keep track of the number of balls in my game. Well, now in GDScript, I can create a static variable. It will be shared between every instance of the script. So this allows me to share data that I don't want to expose via a resource or a singleton. Godot's GD extension technology allows you to use C or C++ for scripting without recompiling the engine. In Godot 4.1, GD extension got a new system for backwards compatibility to help ensure code written for Godot 4.1 keeps working in future releases. Also, on top of creating new nodes and tool scripts, you can now code editor plugins in C++ and define new visual nodes for the shader editor. This brings C++ even closer to GDScript and C# in terms of scripting capabilities. Note that GD extension is still considered in beta in this release, as it needs to be tested widely. Moving on to performance now, there's a lot of work happening around nodes in Godot. Nodes are the basic game object, the basic building block of your Godot games, so you'll get to have lots of them and do lots of operations on them. These operations include adding a node, getting a node by path, and removing them. Godot 4.1 changes the data structure and algorithm used to manipulate nodes, making these operations much faster. Godot 4.1 introduces experimental multi-threading for scenes and nodes. You can now expand the process, thread group, category in the inspector, and change how a given node will be processed. Select subthread to make the node and all its children by default process in a separate thread from the main one. This feature needs extensive testing. This is why it's marked as experimental. Godot 4 introduced the ability to do multi-threaded loading, which is what makes your projects load faster initially. Godot 4.1 fixes the API for that, allowing you to make multi-threaded loading requests much more reliably. So to do that, you call resourceLoader.loadThreadedRequest, and then you call resourceLoader.loadThreadedGet to freeze the function and wait until the threaded load returns. Note that you also have an argument, the third one exactly in this function, use subthreads that can greatly improve the loading speed. So you should try it if you are trying to load complex scenes. The first time you load a shader at runtime, it currently needs to be compiled, which can cause short freezes. Godot 4.1 introduces a shader cache so that after the first compilation, freezes should not happen anymore. There is more to do on that front, but this is a first step in the right direction. Godot 4.0 introduced real-time avoidance for AI navigation, but it was limited. This release includes completely rewritten avoidance algorithms to give you much better behavior and greater control. Avoidance can now happen in 2D or 3D. On top of that, you can now use layers to control which agents avoid which and assign them priorities to have some agents push others away. For a detailed list of all the bug fixes and improvements in this release, check out the new interactive changelog and head to the Godot website for the official release notes. We are hard at work on new learning technology and Godot 4 tutorials. Subscribe not to miss any updates. If you want to meet fellow Godot users and get help learning, join our Discord community. All the links are in the description.